Guys, I haven't done a video in a couple of days and thought I better get back to this. Sorry for not getting to you yesterday. What I want to work on today is finishing up this drawing so that if I were turning it in for final, it can be a little closer to done. This may be the last video. I might have to do one more. I'll zoom in a little so you can see a little better what I'm trying to accomplish. As you can see, there are still some several sketchy areas, like right in here on the hat. And I think I'm just going to start with that and get going. Thought I'd better do this earlier in the morning so that I'm not bombed with emails when I want to be doing a video to show you guys how to finish up your work. Again, I'm just taking the blending stump and going over it. Now, I do have a Q-tip here, and if you don't have a blending stump, Q-tips work just as well. They do the same thing. You might have to press a little harder because they're not quite as stiff and durable as a blending stump, but as you can see, the Q-tip will blend just as easily. I'm going to go back to the blending stump and blend the rest of this in. It gives the hat kind of a smoother feel. I can get kind of a different value up next to the head. I'm going to hook my arm around here and just go along this edge. And there we go. I also want to darken something because there is a shadow on the hat right in here. So I'm going to go in with my carpenter pencil again. Remember, you can get these at any hardware store or builder supply place. And we've got two or three in town that you can get these things from. And they help a lot, and you can do some pretty neat drawings with them. So now I'm going to go back in and I'm going to blend right in this area for the shadow on the hat. And I'm going to take a look here. Yeah, looks like we're doing okay. There we go. And then the shadow comes up in here just a little bit. Okay. Too bad. Do need to go in and work the ear a little bit. So I'm going to slide my computer a little closer to me so hopefully it shows up on the mic or you can hear me better on the microphone. The top of the ear is pretty dark. We'll just kind of shade that in like so. And there's an edge here. A little bit more here. Some shading on my earlobe. Okay, we'll go back in with the blending stump and let's smooth some of this out. Try and get that ear look to it. Again, I hope you guys are keeping up with everything okay. It's been a struggle for me because there's so much new stuff involved with what we're trying to accomplish. But I think we're going to get the hang of it here pretty soon. Lighten this value on the cheek here. There, not too shabby. It looks pretty good. This might be a little too dark on the cheek. I'm just going to take a pink pearl and lighten the whole area up. Now, I know I said that these aren't the best erasers, but they may be the only ones you have. So using them is not a bad thing. Just be gentle with the pink pearl erasers because they do tend to wreck the surface area of your paper if you press too hard. Go in here and work the beard a little bit more. Not particularly happy with the texture here that I'm getting, but I'm going to try and go in with a pencil and give it that more refined kind of curly haired look that my beard is. And again, I hope you guys are doing well, and keeping up with everything. I know I sent out a lot of emails to first hour kids who weren't contacting me, and I have to do that the rest of today and kind of get some information out. Okay, it's looking pretty good there. I'm gonna go up here and blend the hat a little bit. Remember, I use this in kind of a circular motion. Like that. There we go. And then, let's see, I'm just going to keep working here for a while. I don't have a whole lot to say right now, so I'll just let you kind of watch me work on this and see what you think. There we go. It's looking pretty decent. I guess, you know, if it were me, I would call this, you know, for me, I'd say this is B plus work right now because it's not quite finished. And so I need to work a little more on it. I'm going to go in and shade the collar in. Maybe give it a little more shape. See, and if you're watching, you don't need to erase everything in a sketch because sometimes, like I'm doing right now, you're going to draw right over it. So, in that regard, didn't need to worry about it anyway. Here, we're gonna do some shading and you'll see what I mean. This kind of gets rid of those scribble lines I had for the beard there. I do go back and forth on this. It depends on the kind of texture or look you want. I do need to take the shadow out right here because that's the edge of the coat or whatever. Anyway, there's my collar. It shows up pretty good. Now I'm going to throw some shading in on the shoulders, a little lighter. I want there to be some contrast with the collar. See better. Back in here, shade these areas, or blend these areas a little bit. Used to not be a big fan of these blending stumps. I used to never work with them, and I just picked one up this last year and decided to give it a try, and it does make things a little simpler as far as speeding up the process. I did notice that in order to bring things back into focus, you have to go back in with the pencil, kind of work it a little bit more. So I am going to go back in, kind of clean things up with actual just pencil lines. Go back into my shaded areas to kind of bring it back into focus, which is what I'm doing right now. Kind of tighten the drawing up again. Let's see here. Go in, put a little shading in here. Now to try something, I'm gonna just put some lines in on the beard, kind of make it look more curly, get some of that texture going. That's in there, and we'll zoom in a little, let you see it a little better. Yeah, it kind of helps. I'll slide my paper over. So blending it out makes it look kind of out of focus, but I go in now with the carpenter pencil again and just add some curls in the beard, because that's kind of how my beard looks. It's kind of poofy and curly and all that. Going over here. Now I'm going to go in lightly in this area, do some of the same things in the white area of my beard where the light's hitting it directly. Again, my headset and microphone should be coming in any day now, and that should improve the audio quality in the videos. So I do apologize. Again, now I'm just taking this pencil in and kind of putting the edges back on the drawing, because when you're using the blending stump, it's real easy to get enamored with how easy it is to blend that you automatically turn everything gray and out of focus. So I'm trying to bring back some contrast in here, and then the drawing looks a little more finished. Larry in here. There we go. And so, there we have quite a bit of the drawing done now. Well, we're getting pretty close to a finished product. I need to go in and kind of clean the hat up here on the top where it is much lighter. Oh, I'm sorry. I need to zoom out a little bit. Working up here on the hat again. We go. I don't know if this is done yet, but it's getting close, and so I'm gonna go in and tighten up some things on the face and in the eye and stuff like that. Lighten up some areas with the pink pearl. Again, if you're going to use the pink pearl, you got to go real gentle when you're doing it because it can be real destructive on your paper. Anyway, that's what we're looking like there. I've got to figure out a way to deal with this line. I might have to erase it. I don't like to do that, but this is what I have so far. I might need to clean up the glasses a bit. Maybe we'll go in and do that right now. Just kind of lightly go in. Take out the lines you don't need. See how that looks. Not too bad. Go in, lightly go over this area, get rid of that. Going to have to set up a background for this to kind of cover up the marks, but I can do that fairly simply. We'll do that at the next video. Excuse me. But that's looking pretty good now. I'm pretty happy with this. I'll zoom in a couple of spots. Get some eraser crumbs off. So there we have it. That's how you take one of your sketches and you turn it into a final drawing with simple tools, a carpenter pencil, a blending stump, a Q-tip, and a pink pearl eraser. So guys, remember, you can create art with just about anything. Stay positive, keep working hard, and please keep in touch, okay? Love you guys. Have a great day.